though should actually go. No bones in her hand, okay?
Laverne DeFazio, Italian Catholic teamster. Rhonda Lee, huh? Any relation to Pinky?
No. But we have the same agent. Oh, my, it's so stuffy in here.
We opened the door.
Yeah, but it is warm outside.
Holy rhubarbas!
Life stinks. Are those real?
Laverne.
Well, even her doctor would make small talk before he'd ask a question like that.
Talking about her eyelashes.
Oh, only $1.95 a lid.
Boy, you could comb them.
Now that we're practically roomies, would you mind hammering softly? I'm rehearsing for a Dr. Show commercial.
I have a cat.
She doesn't know.
Hi. Dr. Scholl's commercial, huh? You playing Dr. Scholl's?
Oh, heavens, no. I'm the dancing footpad.
Oh, fabulous.
What a sweet little plant. Oh, it's just a beautiful wandering Jew.
Finding what?
Oh, I know my plants, and this is a lovely wandering Jew.
Yes, yes, and that's why I named him Stanley.
What are you talking about?
Stanley? Rhonda Stanley?
Some other time. That reminds me, Rhonda is throwing a little bash tonight. You know, producers, directors, the usual. It is late, but I was just wondering.
Yes? Yes?
May I borrow your ice trays?
Sure.
They love a good party.
Oh, gee. I just knew you girls would be such a help. Just like a pair of dependable old shoes.
Hello. Girls. We have seen Shangri-La, and we know where it is. They call it the beach. You can't miss it. It's right next to the Passaic Ocean.
Yeah.
It's amazing. They got bikini-dressed women wherever you look.
Yeah. Oh, Squake. Look, one of them leaked indoors.
Who is that?
No, can we leave it?
Who is that?
No,
don't
embarrass us.
All right, okay.
Squiggy, Lenny, this is our neighbor, Rhonda.
Rhonda!
Oh, your dates are here. Oh, it's so nice to know there is someone for everyone. Hello. Rhonda's here.
We don't have time now, Rhonda, darling. We're going on our way out.
Well, wherever you're going, it can't be too important. The most fabulous thing has happened to Rhonda.
Don't tell me. You discovered the original color of your hair.
My little theater group is putting on a streetcar named Desire.
And you're playing the streetcar.
I happen to be playing Blanche DuBois. And you and the ladies can help me rehearse. Okay, Shirley, you'll read the part of Stanley. Laverne, you're Stella. Okay, Shirley. Put on the T-shirt and try to sweat.
Rhonda, I don't have time for this right now. I'm going to be late.
Nice touch, but please stick to the script.
Blanche, we got to go somewhere. Now get out of here.
Whoa. Actually, you'd make a much better Stanley.
Stanley.
Rhonda.
Don't want to go, Stanley. Rhonda, if you're not out of here on the count of three, Laverne here is going to shave your head and you'll be playing in The King and I.
I've done it before.
But I've always relied on the kindness of night.
scissors, would you? Oh.
Well, on second thought, you know, I really shouldn't be over rehearsed for this, should I?
Man's a poet.
Hi ho!
Hi ho!
Just on my way to a big Hollywood party. Thought I'd drop by and brighten your dreary day.
Well, it just so happens, Rhonda, that we spent our dreary day co-starring in a movie with Troy Donahue.
Oh, ladies, now, Rhonda wasn't born under a rock.
Yeah, well, just wait until Before Time Began comes out at your local theater or drive-in.
Oh, yeah, then you're going to the cast party in your bathrobes.
Cast party?
Oh, yes, I received my invitation a week ago. Oh, but since I'm going and you're not, I'm sure you won't mind answering Rhonda's little phone. Ta-ta.
You know, we got lots of things to do.
I am so late. I fell asleep at the beach. I have to meet Sonny Den at Cowboy Bill's to practice his knife throwing and be his beautiful assistant. Rhonda, what are you doing in my apartment?
I knew you'd understand. It was a tanning emergency.
Oh, my costume, my costume.
I miss you too, Laverne. Nice place. Shirley? Oh, Lord, please let that be Shirley.
Hi-ho. I'm Rhonda.
Oh, yeah, right, of course. You couldn't be Shirley. You've got more skin.
Are you anybody?
Yeah, I'm Carmine Ragusa. I'm sure the girls told you all about me.
No.
Laverne!
Angel Faye!
Sweetheart, not now. I have a certain bone to pick with a certain Mr. Fazio who ran up a $98 phone bill.
I'll go out and take a cold shower. I'll come back later.
Rhonda, what are you doing in my apartment?
Oh, I'm getting a tan. I have this wonderful new
Rhonda,
lotion.
I really don't care about your life. Did I ever tell you that? Do you know where Laverne is?
After she came back from the beach, she went to Cowboy Bill's.
Oh, she went to Cowboy Bill's. Oh, boy. Wait till I get my hands on her.
Hi, Shirley. Where's Laverne?
She's down at Cowboy Bill's.
Can you open the door for me, please?
Well, sure, why not? I do everything else around here. Go to work, open the door. Just another door.
Oh, I hear Rhonda's little friends are still out of work. So I went through my drawers to help you in your time of need.
Rhonda, I know you mean well, but no thank you.
Oh, brave soul. Here, here, just look at all these goodies. Here, look. There's a pair of shoes. They don't match, so wear them at night. And half a bar of soap.
Ooh, my favorite, Ivo.
And I brought you a nice little dessert. Prunes Rhonda.
Rhonda, this is really very unnecessary.
Oh, yes, it is necessary. And I'm going to tell the whole neighborhood about your unemployment.
No.
And then I'm going to go down to the church and organize your pancake breakfast benefit.
No.
Ciao. Charades! Oh, let me guess, a garden hose. No? I got it, a cucumber, I got it, the headless horseman.
Where is she? Where is she?
Not now, Rhonda, not now. Laverne has to get out of this dress.
Oh, I don't blame her. Maybe Rhonda can help. Oh, I've had lots of
experience getting out of dresses.
Well, lucky for me, Rhonda. Gonna go change, get rid of Paul.
Don't chuck me. Okay, now.
Okay, let's hurry up and go. She's still here.
Yeah, and Rhonda. Rhonda, darling, thank you so much for all your helpful advice.
Oh, thank you. Anytime, girls. I make a point of being nice to everyone. That way, everybody owes me a favor. Ciao.
I don't like her.
Oh, come on. I think she means well.
No. Hi-ho! Shirley! Here are the candles you asked for.
Thank you so much. They're just beautiful. Thank you.
Who's the lucky guy?
Just a handsome pediatrician is all.
Oh, really? What's his name?
Dr. Mark McKenzie.
Whew, I've never heard of him.
Oh, well, perhaps you have seen him. He's been around the building the last 3 weeks.
Oh, him? Oh, yes, I have. But I never guessed those were social calls. I just assumed you were very sick or dying or something.
I'm afraid not, Rhonda. I think it was love at first sight.
Oh.
He came into the customer service department at Bardwell's, looked me straight in the eyes, and said, "Would you please wrap my Mr. Potato Head?"
Oh, how many women have waited to hear those magic words?
No, no, Rhonda. The Mr. Potato Head was for his son.
Oh, then that means
no, no, it's not what you think. He's separated and on his way to a divorce.
Uh-oh. Rhonda smells alimony. No wonder you're not eating out.
Rhonda. Rhonda, thank you so much for the candles. Mark's gonna be here any moment. I'm sure you understand.
Oh, of course I understand. You spent all afternoon trying to look sexy and glamorous. If he walks in and sees me, it'll ruin everything.
Ciao.
Oh, have a very good time.
The humiliation I endure for two lousy candles.